as I try to go behind my goal. It seems my goal is running away from me. When I give my hand in some task, then realize I am not fit for that task. When I try to penetrate my target, then the arrow goes far away from the center, and it looks I will never hit the target. I see a great distance between me and my goal, between the center of the target and the arrow where it hit. Nothing happens in my favor, not even looks like it will happen in my favor. It creates a wave of great disappointment in me. Back-to-back rejections and failures screams that now I should stop trying. I should accept that I'm not that capable. I can't tolerate the laughing and comments of the world at me anymore. I should compromise with rejections and failures, and should surrender and retreat, and be satisfied what I have, and console myself by saying success is not in my luck. I think this would be the best idea. Let the luck become responsible for my failure. The wall of luck is so big, I can easily hide behind that wall. No one can see me there, no one can call me a loser. But I found it won't work, because I can hide from everyone but not from me. I cannot stop to see myself in the mirror. This is not the solution. Then what is the solution? Then I read about Jack Ma, who applied 3 times in university but rejected, applied 10 times in Harvard but not accepted, applied in the police job but failed, and when KFC came in China, 24 candidates applied, 23 succeeded, but he failed. But today, no one knows about those 23, but the world knows about the one who failed. I knew about Michael Jordan, one of the best basketball player in history of his field, who says, "I can accept failure. Everyone fails in something, but I cannot accept not trying." To learn to succeed, you must learn to fail first. And this saying of him shows the level of his determination, persistence, struggle, madness, and the philosophy of trying and not to give up, that I failed over and over and over again in my life, and that's why I succeeded. Then I realized that my failure, my rejections are not even 1%, and I got scared. The great examples of persistence of great people clearly shows they loved the work they were doing, because if they don't love the work they were doing, then they were going to quit. I realized life is not about to achieve the goal, but to try to achieve the goal. After failure, not to quit, but to continue and stand fast in difficulties. Life is to live with purpose, whether I achieve it or not. When fell down, then stand back and walk again with sincere heart, with little more effort than before. Hope never takes its hands back. Then why I am taking my hands back? I must never leave the hands of hope, because if I try with belief, then I would have the chance to succeed. But if I don't try, if I try and fail, then the world will say me a loser, but my conscience will be satisfied. I can see myself in the mirror with proud that I never gave up. When I'll die, I won't have anything inside me, because I lived my life with purpose. I was not directionless. I would have to take rejections positively, because rejections and failures are crucial for growth. Being scared going back and quitting is not the solution at all, but moving forward step by step, one by one, day by day is the solution. I will learn from the failure. I learn from others' mistakes and failures. Rejection is not me failure, but to stop trying is the failure. Being success and failure is in my hand, because until I don't accept that I'm failed, I'm not failed. If I don't give up till my final breath and I don't achieve what I want to achieve and I die, then even I'm not failed because I didn't give up. In fact, I have succeeded. Now I have got my energy back. Now I'm ready to march towards my goal with more energetically, with more belief. I am ready to throw the arrow with more concentration, focus, and with the belief how far it goes from the point. No issue, I will try again and again and again to penetrate the center of the target till my final breath. I won't give up.